Hello everyone, this is Dr. Shochinandan Dotto from Eco Learning, Learning from Home. So today we'll learn about the wetland ecosystem. So at first, wetland is the transitional zone between a truly aquatic habitat and a terrestrial habitat. So it's a transitional zone between the aquatic habitat and the terrestrial habitat. So it's in between these two habitats. And there are currently almost 6.4% of the earth land is wetland. Okay, so it's a totally huge total earth land. 6.4% is the wetland. The primary factor that distinguishes wetland from the other land or the water body in the characteristic where the vegetation and aquatic plant, that's the main thing, that the a normal land could be converted into wetland based on this characteristic of its vegetation and the aquatic plant, and it have to able to adapt it to this unique hydric soil, because it's always hydrated. So hydric soil means it's absorbing lots of water. So that land could be called a wetland. Next, why the wetland are too much important to our environment? First of all, it is the kidney of the landscape. Main thing, that is the kidney of the landscape. What the function of kidney in a organism body? It's filter or it's purifying our body. So wetland is also act as a purifying the environment. Okay, it's act as a kidney of the landscape. Then it's prevent flood. How it can be prevent flood? As the wetland is absorbing a huge amount of water, so when it is flooded, any area is region flooded, so then this water will be absorbed or soaked by this wetland. So it also prevent the flood. It minimize the impact of flood, so that it can be prevent the flood. Protection of shoreline, there will be types of wetland we will see later, that the coastal wetland. That coastal wetland or marine wetland is also protecting the shorelines from the ocean. The storm surges, high tide and these high wind waves are coming to the shoreline, and that shore is also protected by this wetland, as this wetland is protecting this huge storm surges. So like Chilka is a good example of the protected shoreline wetland. Then it's have a huge importance in education tourism. So world good or all the wetlands are a good tourist destination. Like in terms of Indian, we have a good example of the Chilka, then Point Kalimar, then Sundarbans. These all are the wetland, and these are the very good tourist destination. And then cultural value, it has a huge important on the culture of the human society. Cultural value is also related. It is also impacted a huge social impact on this wetland ecosystem, as the maximum wetland there is a huge biological resource. Later we'll see the biological resources. So the peace is one of the major resources in the wetland. So like in Chilka Lagoon, there will be around thousands of fishermen are dependent on this particular wetland. So it has a huge impact on the social value, this wetland ecosystem. Then it's recharge the purifying water. It's recharge our aquifer. So groundwater recharging by the wetland ecosystem, and also it purifying water. So ground, the wetland ecosystem is purifying this the water and recharging our aquifer. Then it has a huge importance to wildlife habitat. So wetland support a huge biological diversity from different types of plants and animals are home to this wetland ecosystem. So it's hold a huge biological diversity. Then it's the main things that it has a good important to stabilize the climate. It is a good actor as a CO2 absorber. So wetland ecosystem is a very good climate stabilizer. It can also absorb a huge amount of CO2, or the sinking of the amount of CO2, to minimize the concentration of CO2 in the atmosphere. So then the types of the wetland. So there are in general three types of wetland. Then it's also depend on different source. So the types of wetland, the first of all it's a swamp, then marshes and the bog. So this type of wetland, or in general the US have a very good of these three types of wetland are there. Okay, so swamps are the depend on nutrient-rich groundwater derived from the mineral and soil. So this is the main thing that all the woodland have a this what this nutrient-rich groundwater. So nutrient-rich water is having every woodland have the same component will be present in the all the wetland. So swamp is the depending on it, and it is the mineral of soil. So like a good example of the Everglade of US Everglade, Florida, US is a good example of the swamp. Then the Mars is the permanently or periodically flooded site and characterized by nutrient-rich water. As I already said, nutrient-rich water is a very common characteristic of the all kind of wetland. So marshland, if you go and visit a marshland, then you can see you believe that this land is always look like a flooded land. Okay, so that's the marshland. Example is the Horicon marshes in western Wisconsin in USA. Okay, then bogs are the made by the peat accumulation, usually dominated by the moss. Here you can see the moss is dominated in the bog ecosystem or bog wetland. Bog are generally formed by the rainwater. Bog are generally formed by the rainwater. So here is a very good Burns Bog in British Columbia. It is the largest peat bog in US, northern US, northern America. Then the other different types of wetland are the marine and coastal zone wetland. Mean this wetland are associated with the ocean or the marine ecosystem, like the Chilka Lagoon. This is the whole Chilka Lagoon associated with the Bay of Bengal. So this is a very good example of marine or coastal wetland. Then the inland wetland. Inland wetland means this wetland is a terrestrial habitat. Mean terrestrial, it's surrounded by in inland region, and this is a very good example, the Iskalkat wetland of India. And Iskalkat wetland of India is a very important wetland in terms of this particular region, because it's really good as a kidney. It absorbing a huge amount of pollution from the domestic sewage to industrial sewage, all kind of sewage it's absorbing. So it's really very play a good role, and it is a very source of biological diversity, and it is a huge economic value. It provided a huge amount of fish production yearly, and this ecosystem is really important to inside a big city like Kolkata. So the inland wetland ecosystem is the Iskalkata wetland. Then the man-made wetland. Man-made wetland means this kind of wetland are created by the man, like a dam or a reservoir. That is also a man-made wetland, like Kenjli wetland in Punjab. So it's a good example of the man-made wetland, and it has a hold a huge biological diversity. Lots of migratory birds are coming to here, and here will be you can find lots of aquatic plants that as the main characteristic of the wetland. It has a huge hydric soil, so that a man-made wetland is the Kenjli wetland. Then we let discuss about the Pudeu in the wetland ecosystem. As wetland is a kidney of nature, it has a hold a huge biological diversity. So then it's a very interesting to see the wetland food web. It's a very complex food web we can found in the wetlands, because that's a it's a terrestrial and it's also aquatic habitat. So mainly it's dominated by aquatic part. So here the main producer of this ecosystem is the phytoplankton and all the aquatic plants, aquatic plant that could be a submerged or could be a floater. Okay, these are the primary producer consumed by the primary consumer, that are the zooplankton or invertebrate or the microinvertebrate or macroinvertebrate. There's zooplankton and invertebrate also eaten by the small fish eaten by the large fish, or large fish also small fish, and large fish also eaten by the lots of aquatic birds like the heron, like the pond heron, like the snake bird, like the egret. And this also invertebrate is also eaten by the frog, and the frog is also, or lots of aquatic insects like water strider, then these are the eaten by this frog, and the frog is also eaten by the snakes and wizard. And in some time the small fish, large fish and the frog and snakes is also eaten by the top predator, that is the kite or a predator birds. Okay, so this is a huge complex ecosystem and a complex food web present in the found in the wetland ecosystem. Then the few common wetland plants we can see. If we see, the cattails is a very common wetland plant found in every wetland. Then the bladderwort, then the algae. So different types of algae. Algal bloom is a very prominent or very dominant in the wetland ecosystem, because the wetland is, I already told, it's a nutrient rich water. So when the nutrient, lots of domestic industrial is coming to this wetland ecosystem, and it's nutrient rich, and this whenever nutrient rich, then the algal bloom is a very common thing can be found in the wetland ecosystem. Then other important common wetland plant, these are the waterweed, duckweed, then water hyacinth, this is also called of terror of Bengal. Okay, then the bulrushes, then the water lily, contail, spike grasses. So this is the very common wetland plant found in each and every wetland. You can find these plants. Then the common wetland animals. So there is a very good resources of biological diversity. So it has smooth coated water to kingfisher, common kingfisher, and there will be several types of kingfisher found in the wetland, like the white-breasted kingfisher to stockbill kingfisher to white-spotted kingfisher. And then the bullfrog, this is a very interesting frog or the amphibian that found in very aquatic habitat, kind of aquatic wetland you can found this thing. And then ducks, the most of the wetland is also important for a migratory bird. So lots of migratory duck is also coming to during the winter season in the tropical wetland, especially in Indian wetland. The lots of Siberian birds or the Himalayan birds coming to this wetland ecosystem for the purpose of their migration during the winter, during November to March. And lots of aquatic birds like pond heron, egret, snake bird. So these are the very common birds found in the all kind of wetlands. And the chicot keelback, this is a aquatic snake found in a very common to all Indian wetlands. Now other common wetland animals are the fishing cat, then the dragonfly, ringle beetle, snail, water strider, tadpole. So these are the very common wetland plants. Then the Ramsar site. Let's discuss about what is Ramsar. So Ramsar Convention was formed due to to recognize the all the wetland ecosystem internationally. So it has a huge international important, the Ramsar Convention. It was happen in the city of Iran, that city's name is the Ramsar. The Ramsar is the Iran city, and that convention happened in 1971. So it's an intergovernmental environmental treaty for the conserving of wetland, and also it's a sustainable use of its resources. So that's Ramsar Conservation Convention is very important for the conservation of wetland ecosystem. So Ramsar identify the wetland internationally important where those providing the waterfowl habitat. Okay, and in according to Ramsar Convention or Ramsar, in 2016 there is almost 2231 Ramsar site around the world, and which total land cover is almost this much of hectare. It's a huge land cover. At I earlier told, it's almost 4.6% of the world land. And 169 international government already participating in this Ramsar Convention. And here the list of Ramsar site in India. India is a huge wetland ecosystem. We have almost 26 wetland ecosystem, and some of them is the Clearwater National Park in Rajasthan. Chilka Lake I already discussed about in Odisha. Kanjali already discussed in Punjab, man-made wetland. Luktal Lake in Manipur. Then the Roper in Punjab. Okay. And each and every Ramsar site have a number, Ramsar site number. Okay, like East Calcutta wetland is 1208, so East Calcutta wetland have this number. So these are the all wetland found in India. Then the threat to wetlands. Okay, so nowadays the wetland ecosystem is a very fragile ecosystem, and it has a huge threat. So from the drainage to filling, so as earlier I have told that all the industrial and domestic sewage are coming to this wetland ecosystem, and the drainage to city drainage to everything is coming to this. So drainage and filling, all the debris, all the city's waste could be dumped in wetland ecosystem. Like a very good example that the East Calcutta wetland. Then the grazing. So grazing, as the wetland ecosystem has a huge nutritious grasses, so it's a very good for the grazing. But this, due to the grazing, this ecosystem has facing a big threat. Then the buildings of dams. So due to the buildings of dams, this wetland ecosystem facing the siltation rate. So siltation in this wetland ecosystem is increasing very high due to the increase of a dam is construction. Then the wetland ecosystem is siltrated, and due to siltation, this wetland ecosystem converted in a normal land, and then it can be converted into this household. That is the infrastructure development, and due to this the wetland ecosystem is also converted into a human habited land, or the lots of concrete building are coming on the wetland ecosystem. Then over exploitation of wetland resources, as wetland is a huge biological resources, so the over exploitation of this, especially the fishery resources, are over exploited from this wetland ecosystem, that have face a big threat to this ecosystem particular. Then invasive species, lots of foreign species or invasive species introduced in this wetland ecosystem, and that could be harmful the natural species or the native species of this particular ecosystem, like lots of foreign species, foreign fish like the tilapia, then the Japanese putti to grass carp. These are the introduced in this wetland ecosystem, and so these are damaging our the native species. Then climate change is a threat to the all kind of ecosystem nowadays. No need to discuss about it, climate change impact on it. Then the mining is also have a biggest threat to the wetland ecosystem. So these are the all about the threat of the wetland ecosystem. How do you conserve the wetland ecosystem? So Ramsar Convention, I have already told about the Ramsar Convention. Ramsar Convention is the first criteria to conserve a wetland ecosystem. So it's an intergovernmental treaty and the framework to provide it the conservation and their resources and the sustainable use of this wetland ecosystem. So Ramsar Convention is the first to conserve the wetland ecosystem, and the restoration is very important to all kind of wetland ecosystem. So whatever we have, whatever the existing wetland, that we need to protect them first of all. Okay, then planning, managing and monitoring is very important, and the stakeholder engagement and the governmental initiation with the non-governmental agencies and the scientists. So it's a very big way to protect this wetland ecosystem. Then the building awareness, as we know that wetland day is the 2nd February, so during the particular day we make awareness to the school children, to the among common people, to not to damaging this ecosystem, to protect this ecosystem, and so this is a very good conservation way. And then research also make lots of difficult questions, can give a lots of difficult question to how we can protect it. So research is required to conserve this fragile ecosystem. And the community conservation. Community conservation is the next step to conserve all kind of ecosystem like Chilka. Chilka is a huge community conservation. So Chilka is a home of the thousands or millions of fishermen, and those fishermen are protecting this particular ecosystem because this is their food, and this is their also home. So that they should protect it for their survival. So community conservation is the new thing. Okay. So that's all. Thank you for listening. If you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe our channel and share our videos, and please hit the bell icon to take the future notification of the video. So thank you all.